Good morning, student. Again, in this chapter, we will talk about conservation of plants and animals. This is your seventh chapter of your science book. Okay, now this is on page number 77. Some of the facts are given in this first paragraph related to Kanjiranga National Park, Lok Chau Wildlife Sanctuary, Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve, and Tiger Reserve. I am your science teacher Bhavani Singh, PGT Biology. Now I will explain some facts related to this chapter, and please listen and underline the page number also. Okay, so conservation means what? Protection of our plants and animals present in our forest. Because why? They give very important for our environment. Okay, now in this chapter we will learn all the facts. First of all, what is deforestation? The cutting down of trees for our benefit is called deforestation. And what is the loss of deforestation to our ecosystem? Deforestation means cutting of trees. If all the trees will cut, then what will happen? The carbon dioxide level will in atmosphere will increase, and the animal have to move. And finally, if the grazing animals does not get the food from there in the forest and their shelter, they will run to some other place, and finally they can get be killed, and finally these animals will disappear, even the plant species. Okay, so deforestation is very big problem for our country also, because the people living near to the forest and jungle area, though for their daily purpose for fuel wood, they cut the trees. For grazing the grass and leaves, they carry there all the grazing animal to the forest, and finally they disturb the other animal which are living freely in the forest. Okay, so it is very important. Okay, one fact is mentioned on page number 76, paragraph 7.1, deforestation and its causes. The trees in the forest are cut for some of the purpose mentioned below. That is already mentioned here, but I explained you in the easy way. Why we cut the forest? For even for timber and furniture also, because we get the fuel for that. Even in area, they cut wood for fuel also. Okay, in the village area, they used to make hut that is also made from wood, sticks and straw. So also they collect all the raw material from there. Okay. And other thing, for industrial purpose also, sometimes they clean the forest and set up the industry. That is also very dangerous, because it causes deforestation and destroy our forest, the natural beauty of our earth. And even the forest are also called the lungs, because they purify the air. Because all of the CO2 produced by burning of fuel, they utilize it during the photosynthesis and finally give out oxygen and water vapor. This oxygen is very essential for our life, because we use it for breathing. Okay, now move on. 7.2, consequences of deforestation. Very important fact mentioned. I underline that you can understand easily. First, temperature of earth will rise. Pollution level will increase. Okay, because if the carbon dioxide level in atmosphere increase, then CO2 level increase and atmospheric temperature will increase, and finally it will leads to global warming. Okay, and if all the trees are removed from that area, then water vapor released during the photosynthesis process that will also reduce, and finally the rainfall will fall in that particular area, and fertility of soil will be completely destroyed. Okay, so we have to protect our forest. And what other benefit we get from the forest is, because when the rain occurs at hilly area, the trees reduce the stop of flowing water, and even also that all the roots of the tree hold the soil particle and reduce the chances of soil erosion, and also they reduce the floods and drought. So it is very important point. Okay, and the photosynthesis role is also mentioned in this paragraph in the last page of 77. Okay, Now we move on next page. What are the important fact mentioned here? Drought, that already discussed with you. Because what happens, the roots of the trees are covered an area of approximately 10 into 10 meter, 100 square meter. So all of the rainwater falls there, all of the minute roots, root hair absorb all of the rainwater and finally increase the seepage. And finally the groundwater level rises and it reduces the chances of drought. But if deforestation done, what will happen? And trees were not there, the water will not go down into the soil and finally the water level will reduce and finally it will cause drought in that particular area. One thing is also mentioned in this page, desertification. What is desertification? Encroachment of desert, increase of the desert area, because if the trees are removed then soil will migrate from one place to another place. That is called wind erosion. And finally, by wind it is erosion and we call it soil erosion. So if the upper layer of the soil that contains the humus, humus is what? Brown degrading material, organic material that is rich in nutrient which is required for our plants and crops. If the soil erosion take place, then thus all fertility will reduce and finally we can't grow the plant there. And finally what happens? This fertile land convert into desert area. That is called desertification. It is very, very important fact mentioned on your page number 72 in this paragraph. So please read properly. Okay. Yes. Okay. Even one thing is mentioned in this paragraph, deforestation also leads to decrease the water holding capacity of soil, that already explained to you. And the movement of water from the soil surface into the ground is reduced, that I explained to you. And all the mentioned thing, nutrient level also reduces, texture of the soil is got disturbed. These all facts are very, very important. Okay. Now, next is conservation of forest, 7.3, page number 72. The everywhere in paragraph, Bujo and Paheli, these two people are in every chapter because for that your chapter become interesting. And in this chapter, one scientist name or environmental scientist named Professor Ahmed is mentioned everywhere because he works for the protection of forest and wildlife. Okay, so we move on this one. This yellow box is very important, some important fact related to this one for your great knowledge. Biosphere is the part of earth in which living organism exist or which support life. Biological diversity or biodiversity refer to the variety of organism existing on earth, their interrelationship and their relationship with the environment. Little bit difficult definition, but I explain you in very easy way. What is biosphere? A very big area where all the animals and plants grows and lives naturally. There is no human disturbance, nobody can go inside. Biosphere, very big area where all the living and non-living interact with each other, and finally plants grows itself. There is no human disturbance and the animal also lives there and their life moves in smooth way. Okay, that is called biosphere. We have three biosphere hotspots in India. One is called the Western Ghat, that covers the area of Maharashtra, Konkan, Goa and Kerala. In this belt, the reptiles and amphibians are present. One another biosphere hotspot is Himalayan Range, and another third one biosphere reserve is the Indo-Burma border, where all the seven sister Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Meghalaya, Assam, all this area. What happens? Their rainforest are present. So various type of animals we can see there, and the different kinds of plants, variety and species grows there naturally. Okay. Okay, now move on the this one paragraph. Professor Ahmed mention very few names in this paragraph. This is Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. This Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve is present in Madhya Pradesh at the border of where the Maharashtra and MP border combine. Panchmadi Resort. Sorry, Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. Okay, you can read from the books. All the things, even Western Ghats are also mentioned here in this paragraph. Himalayan peak. This one, okay, belongs to lower, this one part. It is already mentioned everything here. Okay, now move on this box for something to we can learn. Okay, biosphere reserve is very very big area, very big. Okay, and in a biosphere reserve, a small area that is called national park, and inside a national park it can be further divided into wildlife sanctuary. If we compare by the area, biosphere reserve is a very big place in which all the mountains, range, trees, forests, plain area, rivers, ponds, lakes, all are involved, and different kind of animals live there freely. National park, it is a particular area that is, we can say, restricted only for animal, and it is protected by the government rule, government law also. Nobody can enter and disturb the animals. But wildlife sanctuary is a very small area. For example, in our area we have Tal Chhapar Wildlife Sanctuary. It is protected for cheetal, sambar, chikara, and fox, hyena, monitor lizard, and king cobra. Snakes are present, and even rabbit also we can see there. So if when you get the chance to visit there, please see. Okay, now we will move on the next page. Some important fact here. Biosphere reserve, already I explained you. Okay, in this page, that is page number 80, paragraph 7.5, flora and fauna. Flora means all the plants, and fauna means all the animals at that particular area. If okay, we will discuss what are the animals that are present in any national park or biosphere reserve. Some of the animals are mentioned. Okay, first one is, do you know the name? Okay, now we will discuss. This one animal is called wild dog. This is wild dog. Okay, this is called cheetal. Okay, cheetal. And C1 is called wolf, bigger than dog. Okay, and D is leopard. Diagram E is fern, a special kind of plant, gymnosperm plant, grows in the forest and biosphere reserve. And the last one, F is jamun tree. Okay, we get the fruit. Now move on some next page. Endemic species. Very important definition mentioned. Endemic species are those species of plants and animal which are found exclusively in a particular area. Now what is the very important fact? That if an animal get the particular environmental habit and food and shelter in proper way, the animal found in a particular area. Same way, if the soil is fertile, okay, and climate is also suitable, the special kind of plant grows only where. Okay, can you grow the apple trees in the Rajasthan? No, it is not possible because of environmental condition, because it requires cold temperature, and Rajasthan, it is very hot desert, so we can't grow the apple in Rajasthan. Same way, the endemic species require temperature and climatic condition that is useful for their survival. Like one example is mentioned here, Madhavji shows sal tree. Sal tree is a wild mango. Sal tree and wild mango, what is that? These are the special kind of plants grows in a particular area. Okay,
you can see the diagram. This is wild mango. Okay, that are very important. So these are, now another thing is mentioned is endemic flora of Panchamali. Which one is? These two, sal and wildlife mango, are the endemic flora of Panchamali. Flora means plant. Okay, some animals are also mentioned, like flying squirrel. Flying squirrel, okay. What is flying squirrel? You can see the squirrel which is present at nearby your home, jumping on the trees. But the tree, this special squirrel can, we can say, use their side skin as a wings, and finally it can glide in the air. So that present only in this particular area. Okay, Professor Ahmed name is also mentioned because they protect this environment, working for this area. Okay, what is the definition? This is mentioned here, species. Okay, like I am giving you the example, all the human beings are the species of, and scientific name is Homo sapiens. Same way, dog is also a special kind of species, and other different kind of birds are a specific species. Okay, because why they important? They can interbreed with each cell, and finally they can give rise to the population of their own kind. The species is very important. And even if the species of a particular forest is killed or destroyed, the all the food chain will disturb, and finally it will destroy the our environment. Okay, so species is very, very important for growing of the trees, for pollination, for development of new seedling by the normal germination of the seed. That all depends upon animals, and they work it slowly. Okay, now move on the next page. Okay, on page number 82, your wildlife sanctuary is mentioned. Again, Professor Ahmed is explained that killing, poaching and capturing animal in general is strictly prohibited and punishable by the law in all the such a places, wildlife sanctuary, because nobody can enter in the wildlife sanctuary without the permission from the government and guard, and nobody can kill the animal in their natural environment. Okay, what happens? Because some people living near to the wildlife sanctuary, their activity sometimes disturb the animal, like they carry their animals for grazing in that particular area. Even some people collect the medicinal plant and firewood also, that also sometimes cause disturbance and destroy the wildlife sanctuaries. Okay, it is not allowed. Some of the things are mentioned in this paragraph also. The threatened species. Threatened means if these animals are not protected by us in few year, if normally their shelter will disturb and some people hunt them in the night, what happens? All animal will disappear. Not a single animal we can see alive. That's why it is very, very dangerous. Okay, some threatened wild animals are black buck. It's a special kind of black deer, white eye buck. This it is also white eye deer, elephant, golden cat, pink head cuckoo, ghadiyal, marsh crocodile, python, rhinoceros. Do you know about rhinoceros? It has a horn on his nose. That is very, very important. This horn is used for decorative purpose. That's why some people used to kill these animal. It should not be allowed. Okay, we have to protect our all the wildlife. Okay, and this is what, on next page you can move this area, this paragraph also some facts are mentioned. Okay, it is a pity that even protected forests are not safe because people living in the neighborhood encroach upon them and destroy them. Children are reminder of their visit to the zoo. They call the zoos are also place where animals receive protection. Okay, that's why we are having the zoo, because some of the animal which remains only few, we carry them in a protected environment called zoo, provide them proper shelter, protection, food, nutrition, and if they are sick, they are treated by doctors. Okay, that is the role of our people. Now, national park. नेशनल पार्क, वन नेम इज मेंशन हियर, सतपुड़ा नेशनल पार्क, इट इज इन द मध्य प्रदेश. इफ यू विजिट देयर यू कैन सी ऑल ऑफ द एनिमल. वट आर द थिंग आर प्रिजर्व देयर, दैट इज मेंशन हियर, फ्लोरा फाउना लैंडस्केप एंड हिस्टोरिक ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द एरिया. हिस्टोरिक ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द एरिया इज वॉट, इन सतपुड़ा फॉरेस्ट मैनी केव्स आर प्रेजेंट. एंड फाइनली वेन दिस केव्स आर डिस्कवर्ड, इट इज फाउंड दैट दीज आर अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 10,000 ईयर ओल्ड केव्स एंड दे कंटेन सम स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ प्री हिस्टोरिक पेंटिंग, वॉल पेंटिंग मेड अप ऑफ अ नेचुरल कलर वाइट रेड एंड ग्रीन मेड फ्रॉम ट्रीज. ओके, दीज पेंटिंग शोज द लाइफ ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड ट्राइबल पीपल लिविंग इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया. सम ऑफ द हंटिंग सीन्स आर मैंशन इन द डायग्राम एंड पेंटिंग, यू कैन सी दैम. इवन दीज पेंटिंग्स आर अवेलेबल, their image is available on net, but you don't use the net, you have to read through the book only. That is mentioned in this area. 55 rock shelters have been identified in Panchmadi Biosphere Reserve. Okay, these are painting and many tribals still live in that particular area. Satpura is a tiger reserve area. What is tiger reserve? Basically, we know that it is the biggest cat tiger. And their number at the time of 1928 was approximately more than 50,000. But by extensive killing by the Indian kings and Britishers for making the fun and enjoying the life and showing their cruelty, the number had got reduced. And finally, what happens in 1972, one project was initiated called Project Tiger, and it was started in the 73. And what is the role? All of the special protected area was made for tiger only. And finally, the population of tiger is growing. In Rajasthan, we have Ranthambore National Park for tiger. Even we have Sariska Sanctuary, that is also for tiger. These are the two sanctuaries we are having, especially for tiger. Now, tiger is population is increasing because we are protecting them. Nobody is disturbing them in the environment. Tiger is very, very beautiful animal, but very, very powerful. It shows the power. Okay, very important. Even some other animals are also present in our forest, like buffalo, barasinga. All these are numbers are increasing. These are called endangered animal because their number are very less. We have to protect them. We have to protect them and also their shelter also, and we protect them from hunting also, and we provide them some source so that they can survive and their number can increase and coming our generation can see these animal alive. Okay, this is called wild buffalo. Okay, this is wild buffalo, and some other things are also. This is called barasinga. Barasinga means just because of his horns. Okay, these animals are also being killed for their horn because for decorative purpose this is used, but it should not be allowed. Okay, now move on something other thing. You will read this paragraph just below the diagram 7.6 barasinga. You will learn something. Okay, ecosystem. Again, ecosystem mention, word mention is, what is ecosystem? The particular area where all the living organism interact with non-living. For example, microorganism, small animal, big animals, and all with small grass, leaves, trees. Okay, this river, pond, lake, all of the climatic component are present. And finally, we combine the living and non-living where all these interact with each other is called ecosystem. Okay, page number 84, Red Data Book. It is one of the international book mentioned by international authority that keeps the record of all the endangered animals, because what is their number, how much they are present, and they keep on eye of the record and provide them basic requirement. Okay, they keep all the records of this endangered animals. Now next one is migration. Migration is what? I think sometime you have seen the migratory birds flying on over the sky,
at very high altitude. Basically, for the hospitable environment, they migrate from one country to another country, and continuously they fly for 45 days. I think you have seen Siberian crane every year visiting Ghana National Park. Different kind of millions of million birds visit India, because at that time in the temperature at their particular area in Siberia reduce below 44 degree, minus 44 degree Celsius, and finally the condition are not hospitable to survive in that particular area. So all the animals fly from there and reach to India, where they live for 6 months, and they can get plenty of food, shelter and protection. And even the people go there, visit and take their photos and make the documentary and do the research on these birds, and they are protected by our government. So these are migration. Migration is necessary, and these birds live here for 6 months, and finally they fly back to their own country when the environment becomes hospitable, or we can say adaptable to them. Okay, and the last one is recycling of paper. Do you know, if we cut one tree and finally we can make 1000 notebook, that means it is already mentioned here, if we cut 17 fully grown trees, we can make 1 ton of paper. That means trees are used to cut for making the notebooks and books. So if we recycle the papers, we can protect the 17 trees. So never burn the paper, always after every year when your notebook gets full, and don't burn it, don't throw in the garbage, it sell it to hawker so that it can be recycled. And recycling only involves use of electricity and water, and finally we can save more than hundreds of hundred trees every year. So recycling is the best process. And now is reforestation. What is reforestation? Reforestation means cutting down trees, the area you have to plant all the new plants there. Reforestation, planting more and more trees so that you can protect your forest also, and you can increase the number of trees, because trees are very important. What are the major important function performed by trees? First, they provide oxygen for breathing. They purify the air. Second, third, they give out the water vapor in the photosynthesis process that brings the rain. Okay. Fourth, they reduce soil erosion. Five, they check the floods. Six, they improve the soil fertility. Seven, they give us food. Eight, they give us medicine. Nine, they give us some seeds. Okay. 10, they give us some wood for timber and some other work. And even they provide shelter to the animals. These are the role played by the trees. Okay, so in this chapter we have learned about endemic species, biosphere reserve, red data book, migration, recycling of plant, reforestation. Please go through the NCERT book, read all the pages and learn some important fact mentioned in the lines. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Take care.